Yes, I, and a big, big yes, I to all of you. Let me first tell you the word dhanyosmi, which means gratitude. So this word dhanyosmi came in my life with Lakshmi Srini. She gives me these amazing Sanskrit words, which I bring into my programs. So the first time I was looking for something very beautiful for gratitude, she said dhanyosmi to me. And I thought it was such a beautiful, rhythmic word full of Baba's love. It just kind of resonated with me. But what is dhanyosmi? What is gratitude? So I want to start by telling you my experience of gratitude. You know, in life, we know a lot of things, but we learn them only when we experience them. We learn them only when they deeply touch our core. When I was going through a lot of challenges and difficult times, and I wanted to make things better with situations, with people, with my life, I started just doing a simple thing. I started including gratitude in my meditations. I started doing dhanyosmi in my meditations. I started looking for people that I needed to thank in my life. People I had long forgotten. People I didn't know that, you know, that I should have expressed gratitude when it happened. And you will be surprised to know that what opened up was unbelievable, because it was not huge gratitude that opened up. Small little instances started opening up in my mind. And when I say mind, I'm talking of my mind in a meditative state. It is not in the regular active state. It's in a state of deep calmness. So what opens up is very surprising for you. You think, oh, was I supposed to say a thank you here? Did I? I did not. So from the bigger things to the smaller things that matter, I started expressing gratitude. And I think somewhere my own energies started changing after that. I started becoming so much more positive despite the problems. I felt more strength. I felt more physical energy inside myself. And I surely felt mentally very strong. And I thought, what is this? I'm just saying thank you. I'm not doing anything phenomenal, anything big. Why am I feeling all of this? Then I started reading up more and studying more and finding out more. And I came across a lot of researches and documents and papers, which, you know, I love reading. So I read all of this somewhere or the other. And I reached a lot of such places where I realized that doctors and medical practitioners and scientists have been studying this gratitude very deeply. And their learnings have been amazing. I've read a lot. I can't share all my researches and stories with you, but I'll share the one which I remember very closely. This was a survey done in by a university and the professors and a team of doctors also with them. They picked up, handpicked 300 youngsters who was not youngsters, really all ages, I think, majority youngsters, yes, because it was from a college. So they had their own children there as well. These were people who were suffering from mental sickness, anxiety, depression, and similar disorders. They divided them into three portions. One set of people, and they had all come to them for counseling, because this was a space where they had doctors and professors and counselors. So these people had actually come here for counseling. They said, we will give you counseling, but along with that, you have to do some exercises. So one third of them were asked to write down gratitude messages every day. People who mattered in their life, in their past life, they had to, exactly what I had done actually, weirdly enough, pick people that had made a small or big difference in their life and write a nice gratitude to them. The other part of them were asked to write down messages for people who had caused them displeasure. So one is a completely positive energy, one is a completely negative energy, a displeasure, okay? Which means somebody who has made you uncomfortable, somebody who has called you dis-ease, as we say, displeasure. The third set was asked to do nothing, just take the counseling. Do nothing else, just take the counseling. What happened? It went on for 10 weeks. First test was after 10 weeks. the set of people who had gone through the written gratitude were doing phenomenally well mentally, were doing amazingly well physically, because they had come feeling broken, tired, lethargic, lifeless. I can't do anything more. I'm crashing. This is the end. Totally negative. It had completely transformed into positive energy. And those that had taken up displeasure were not improving at all despite the counseling and feeling very low still. And the third set was just reaping the benefits of the counseling. So second lot was actually going backward, because they were living with a toxic energy, as they say, displeasure energy. There was another thing they found in the survey, which I found very, very interesting. I must share with you. It said that the people who had written the gratitude, there was one word that was repeated several number of times, which came into the eye of the people who were doing the research. The word was we. Okay, think about it, we. And the paper which had displeasure had them, they, him, her, you. Allegation. Displeasure with people. When there is gratitude, there is happiness, there is oneness. It comes into a we mode. They were healing because they were in a mode of oneness, as Baba teaches us. The moment you realize the oneness of all beings, the oneness of everything, you go into a deep state of bliss and happiness. And the moment you break away and distance yourself from people, you get into displeasure and dis-ease. I want you to understand what is gratitude and start to make it a part of your lives. It has to be beautiful. When you get up in the morning, you don't have to meditate. You just have to sit for 5 minutes and just do a gratitude. Do it to Baba. Do it to the cosmos. Do it to your dear ones. And do it to those who are not your dear ones. And do it to those who cause you pain. Do it to those who cause you trouble. You will see the energy start changing, because they say gratitude is the only two-way energy. For example, if you have a child, which happens a lot, you do so much for your children, they just take it for granted. Mama is doing, Papa is doing, what's the big deal about it, you know? What is there about it? It's okay, you're doing it for us. But if they turn around and give you a hug suddenly one day and say, thank you, that was amazing, you just feel a surge of energy inside, you know, like, oh, my child said a thank you to me. There's a surge of energy. It builds a two-way bond. It makes you closer. That is why they always say that you must express gratitude to your God, to your Guru, because your God is constantly, always, at every moment doing something for you. You may know it, you may not know it. You may realize it, you may not realize it. You may see it, you may not see it. Does not mean He is not doing it. If you are breathing right now, it's His blessing. If you're sitting with me and we are doing a satsang here today, good energy, it's His blessing. If we have been chosen to do seva in this life, it is His blessing. If we are healthy enough to be sitting here in our bodies, physical bodies, fine, and talk to each other, this is a blessing. So from the fact that I wake up every morning and open my eyes is my blessing. The fact that I can go back to a bed after eating a meal and sleeping is a blessing. And all this gratitude has to go where? It has to go to Baba, our God, our Guru, our everything. If I'm not expressing gratitude, what is Baba going to think? Look at my child, just as you think for your child. It's not that you expect from your child. You just feel happy when your child says thank you to you. It's not a mother or a father's expectation or conditional love, you know, say thank you, otherwise I won't bless you. You'll anyways love them. You'll anyways be giving to them. But if you say, if they say a thank you to you, you just feel so warmed up and happy in your heart. That's what happens with Baba. When you just go and give him a hug and say, Baba, thank you for all that you do for me. He just becomes so excited and happy, you know, that my child thought of me. My child acknowledged my presence. That is gratitude. Sai Ram, Sai Shyam, Sai Ram, Sai Shyam, Sai Ram, Sai Shyam, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Sai Shyam. Hai ati sundar tera. Sai.
time.